Hello everyone. In this question, we are given that two identical beads, A and B, each of mass M, is connected by a light rod or massless rod of length r root 2 and can slide without friction on a fixed ring of radius small r. The beads are also connected to fixed points C and D with identical elastic cords, each of force constant K and relaxed length is r root 2. Now, initially, the cords coincide with diameters of the ring and the system is in equilibrium. So, now the bead rod assembly is displaced slightly aside and released. Find the acceleration or point of intersection of the cords immediately before the cord becomes relaxed. So, you can pause the video and give a try to this question. And later on, you can come and look at the solution part. So, in the solution part, so I have drawn various diagrams over here. We will see one by one. So the first diagram represents the initial condition. So initially you can see that if I consider C and D point as a chord, yeah, if I consider this as a chord, then I can say that this chord subtends an angle of 45 degree at point A. So this point is at point A. This is simple geometry. You can see over here that AD distance is root 2R, DC distance is root 2R. So this angle will be 45 degree. Similarly, if I consider this massless rod joining the particles A and B, so you consider this as a chord. So this AB chord subtends an angle of 45 degree at point D. So this angle APD, this angle is 90 degree. You can say this angle over here is 90 degree. Now, suppose I've drawn some general instant in this second diagram. In this second diagram, I have considered some general instant. Okay, so let us say at any general instant, this dumbbell, this rod, light rod joining the two particles A and B, this has turned by certain angle over here. Now, this DC length is fixed. Okay, the CD length is fixed. These are fixed points. So again, you can say that this, since this chord CD, okay, it will again subtend an angle 45 degree at point A. Because this is a chord of a circle and this chord will always subtend a fixed angle at any point on this circle. So at this point A dash, this CD chord is subtending angle 45 degree. And similarly, I can say that this chord A dash B dash, okay, this will subtend angle 45 degree at point D. So the angle APD, this angle always remains 90 degree. Now this is an important observation over here. So you can say that DPC, this angle over here is always 90 degree. So what must be the locus of point P? Now definitely from basic mathematics, you can say that if this angle DPC is always 90 degree, then this point P must be moving in a circle. Okay, this is moving in a circle such that this line CD is the diameter of that circle. Okay. So if DC is the diameter, then point E is the midpoint of this CD line and this point E will represent the center of the circle in which point P is moving. So I can say that the radius of the circle in which point P is moving, that is simply half of DC length, which is R by root 2. So this is our first conclusion over here. Next, you can see that the line joining point E and P, okay, so suppose this line has certain angular velocity. Then the line joining point O and particle B, okay, this line, the line joining O and particle A, all these three lines must have same angular velocity. Why I'm saying so is because in a certain time interval, when this point B reaches or turns through 90 degree, okay, this angle BPC, this is 90 degree. So if this particle B turns through 90 degree, that means reaches point C, in that interval, this point A will also turn through 90 degree and this point P will be coinciding with this point C. So all these three points, A, B and P, all these three points will be turning by 90 degree in the same time interval. Therefore, I can say that the angular velocity of point P about point E and the angular velocity of particles A and B about point O, which is the center of this bigger circle, must be same. So I've considered that angular velocity as omega. Okay, I've said this as omega. Now in the question, we have said that we need to find the acceleration of P when the elastic cords just become relaxed. So that condition is shown in this third diagram. So when these cords will become just relaxed, एट दैट पॉइंट द पार्टिकल बी एंड द पॉइंट पी मस्ट कोइंसाइड विद पॉइंट सी. ऑल दिस थ्री पॉइंट्स विल बी कोइंसाइडिंग एट दिस इंस्टेंट. ओके, सो एट दिस इंस्टेंट सिंस द एंगुलर वेलोसिटी ऑफ ओ ए लाइन, ओ बी लाइन एंड ई पी लाइन, ऑल दिस एंगुलर वेलोसिटीज आर सेम. सो आई कैन से दैट द पार्टिकल ए मस्ट हैव अ स्पीड ऑफ आर ओमेगा, पार्टिकल बी मस्ट हैव अ स्पीड ऑफ आर ओमेगा. ओके, सो बोथ द स्पीड्स ऑफ ए एंड बी विल बी सेम. You can also say this by using the constraint relation, since they are connected by a rod. So the velocities, relative velocity along the rod must be zero. So by that method also I can say that the velocities must be same. Now at this particular instant when the strings just become relaxed, before this the angular velocity of the system is continuously increasing because the elastic cords will be having some extension and they will be continuously doing some work on this system, so the angular velocity will keep on increasing. So I can say at this particular instant when point P reaches point C, at this instant when angular velocity is maximum, at this instant the omega will be maximum. So if omega is maximum at this instant, so angular acceleration of the particle P, sorry, point P with respect to its center E must be zero. Because if omega is maximum, so alpha must be zero. So point P is moving in a circular path. Now we know that in a circular path, a point will have two acceleration. One will be the tangential acceleration and the other will be the centripetal acceleration. But since alpha is zero at this particular instant, because omega is maximum, so I can say that the tangential acceleration of point P must be zero. Tangential acceleration of P will be zero. So the only acceleration that point P is going to have is the centripetal acceleration, which will be directed towards point E, which is the center of the circle in which point P is moving. So the net acceleration of P will be in minus J, minus I cap direction towards left at this particular instant. Now we know the value of centripetal acceleration can be given as omega square times the radius in which this point is moving. So angular velocity of EP line is omega. And it is moving in a circle of radius r by root 2. So omega square r by root 2 will be the acceleration of point P at this instant. So if I can calculate the value of omega, I can calculate the net acceleration of point P at this instant. So for calculating the value of omega, we can simply use work energy theorem. So only the elastic forces are doing work over here. There is no effect of gravity. So what is the work done by elastic forces? I'm using the expression minus half k final square minus k initial square. So finally, the extensions in the cord is zero because at this final situation, the cords are in relaxed state. So the final extension is zero. What is the initial extension? If you look at any one particular cord, let us take the example of AC cord. So you can say that the initial length is 2R. And the relaxed state is root 2R. So the initial extension is 2R minus root 2R. So half K initial extension square. This is the work done due to elastic force of any one cord. So for the other cord also it will be same. So I have multiplied this by 2. So if you take, just solve this expression, you will get KR square into 6 minus 4 root 2. Okay. So this is the net work done by the elastic forces. What is the change in kinetic energy? Initial kinetic energy of the system is zero. It is given that the system is released from this position. And the, finally, the speed of particle A is R omega and B is also R omega. So I have written kinetic energy is half mv square, which is R omega square. And since there are two particles, so I have multiplied this expression by 2. So this becomes mr square omega square. So you can equate these two terms. Net work done is change in kinetic energy. So you'll get the value of omega square as k by m 6 minus 4 root 2. Now if I get the value of omega square, now I know the value of omega square. So I can say that the acceleration of point P, this is omega square r by root 2. So you put the value of omega square over here. This is k r by m root 2. 6 minus 4 root 2. So this will be the acceleration of point P. If you want to write it in vector form, you can say this will be minus I cap direction. So this will be the acceleration of point P.